What's up, guys? It's CZ here. Welcome back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Deck of the Day. Today we're doing an update on the ABC deck profile, a deck that I unfortunately have to update because, once again, it has found itself collateral damage. It's been such a long time since Konami started hitting this deck for no reason, just because they wanted to hit other stuff. I remember when A Assault Core went to 1 because of a firewall loop, ABC Dragon Buster went to 1 because they thought that it was going to be too good for MR5, even though we already knew it was not going to. And now, finally, Union Carrier got banned. That was the last nail in the coffin for another hit that actually hurt this deck so big time. Like, people are complaining about this deck. Fans of this deck are just quitting the deck because they know just how big of a hit that was, even though it was meant to be for Drytrons. So I wanted to do an update for the deck just to try to see if it was going to be nearly as good as it used to be. And it's still playable, that's for sure, but you have to adapt to a very different playstyle. So if you wanted to play more of a combo ABC deck, hate to break it to you, but that's not possible anymore. You cannot play Photon Orbital to go for Galaxy Soldier because you cannot equip it with your Union Carrier, so being able to go for Infinity is not a possibility anymore, and so much combo potential has just gone through the window. So if you want to play the deck now, you have to adapt to the strategy of the trap deck, a strategy that we saw in the past. People were using it before, but they just went away from it to go for more combo. But now you have to go back to this version if you want to play ABC, and I know that true fans of the deck are actually going to, because they want to play the deck even though Konami has been mistreating this deck for such a long time now. So yeah, I'm going to show you the list I've come up with. If you have any other ideas on how you can improve the deck, then please share in the comments below. Before we begin with this video, if you enjoy it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss upcoming content, and now let's get to the deck profile. So to start off with the pieces, we have 3 copies of A Assault Core, 3 copies of B Buster Drake, and 3 copies of C Cross Wyvern. So before, you could get away with playing 2 of some of these, mainly A and C. You were going to play 3 copies of B anyway, but now you have to absolutely max all of them because you have to be able to go to the monsters you need, even though if you cannot go to a Union Hunger and you cannot get them to the grave very, very fast without it because you don't have Galaxy Soldier anymore, so it's not like you can discard them from your hand if you don't have the field spell. So you need to be able to sometimes set them on the field and have a slow start and then grind out with your trap cards and then eventually go for a ABC Dragon Buster, and once you do that, then you can start beating down your opponent. So you need to max out on all of them. I know that sometimes you can see a lot of monsters in your hand, and since you play traps, if you don't see too many traps, you might get overpowered, but yes, that's unfortunately how you have to play the deck right now. And I know that it's not the most viable deck right now, but still it's a deck that a lot of people enjoy, so we have to try to make it as competitive as possible. 1 copy of Union Driver. It's a card that you have to play with Hunger because it bypasses the restriction of Hunger not being able to special summon the B exactly the same turn that you equip it, so you can go for your Platinum Gadget and then go for the Dragon Buster this way by searching the third piece. This is the only way you can go for Dragon Buster turn 1, by having a Union Hunger or by having any piece along with unauthorized reactivation. It's the only way to get to it, otherwise you have to grind it out. For hand traps, you have to play quite a lot right now, especially in the format we're in. So the first one is 3 copies of Ash Blossom. Of course, it's the one that you're going to find most useful in pretty much every matchup. She's never going to be dead no matter what you're facing. 3 copies of Nibiru. You have to play Nibiru this format. Last format, Nibiru was not that optimal, but right now the Dragon Link is the best deck, and it's even better than we thought it was going to be because Konami did the mistake of bringing back the Buster Distraction Sword for some reason because they thought it was not going to be a problematic card without Union Carrier. But yeah, it was going to be because people always find ways to abuse broken stuff. So now, if you don't want to get completely destroyed by an extra deck lock, you have to play Nibiru, because other hand traps cannot stop Dragon Link that much. As Blossom, yes, you can use her, but she won't do much unless your opponent has a very mediocre hand. But Nibiru is the one card that you can completely destroy your opponent. And 3 copies of Gamma with 1 driver, because again, in a combo format, I think Gamma is so much more important than playing something like a Veiler or Imperm. If you're afraid that you're going to lose to stuff like Anaconda Dragoon, then you can swap out the Ashes with the Veilers or Imperms if you think that they're a bit underwhelming, depending on the format you're playing. And also, Gamma is a really good card because you play Hunger, so sometimes you start your turn without having a monster on the field, and Hunger is such an important card that your opponent is going to waste an Ash on it most of the time, so being able to go for your Gamma there is really good, and then you can go for a Mask Arena to have him on more plays with that. For the spells, play 3 copies of Unit Hunger, 1 Terraforming. Of course, you have to play as many copies of this card as possible. It's the best card in the deck. It's the card you always want to see in your hand, so you have to maximize on it. 3 copies of Unauthorized Reactivation. This is a combo piece and a defensive card. So first of all, with this card, you can do pretty much the same thing dealing with hunger as long as you have drawn one of the 9 combo pieces. And this is why I said that you have to max them out, because sometimes if you don't open hunger and you open unauthorized, if you haven't drawn a piece, then you're not going to do anything with it. So you need to play as many as possible, which is 9. Also, this card is also a defensive card. Sometimes when your opponent uses something like a Dark Ruler No More or a Droplet on your Dragon Buster, by chaining this card, because it's a quick play, you can equip a B and make it unaffected by spell cards, and your opponent will not be able to do anything. Of course, if your opponents discard a spell with Droplet, you will not be able to do that, but most of the time they will only be discarding monsters. So you can protect your Buster this way, because if your Buster gets stuff like Dark Ruler No More or Droplet and you're not able to tag out, then you're not going to be able to do much, because you will not have the follow-up if you don't get your pieces back from the Banished Zone. So this is why it's very, very important to be able to protect your Buster until it tags out, so you can go into the second or third copy eventually. Play one copy of Call by the Grave, of course. You have to make sure that your cards dissolve. And Rolling Lockbird is a card that hurts this deck a lot. I don't know if people are going to keep playing it, because Drytron is not that big of a threat anymore. But when we get Diviner of the Herald in Lightning Overdrive, then maybe people will start playing Drytron again. So I think Call by the Grave is a card you need to play. And of course, stopping an Ash Blossom on your hunger is always very important. And one copy of Monster Reborn. Usually you will be bringing back your ABC Dragon Buster with this card, because bringing back a Buster is such a powerhouse. Having two copies of Buster on the field can actually win you games on its own, so that's why I really like Monster Reborn in the deck. And I do play a lot of traps, so the trap lineup is very important, because you have to grind it out sometimes, and even though having Dragon Buster on the field can be a good enough disruption, it's not enough against the huge combo deck. Against Eldritch it might be, but against Dragon Link it's not, so you need to be able to interrupt them with multiple ways. So the first card is not actually interruption, but it's a card I really enjoy playing the deck, and that's two copies of Union Scramble. So the reason this card is here is the reason I mentioned before, that if your Buster gets stopped in any way possible from tagging out, then you are not going to be able to combo again, so you need to get those pieces back from the Banished Zone somehow. So this is the card I've chosen to do so. So this is the insurance strategy in case Buster gets dealt with without it being able to use its effect. Two copies of Dynomiscus, really good card. You pretty much discard anything to banish a card on the field. It's a much better trap than pretty much anything else that you have for something like a Karma Cut or a Phoenix Windblast, because it banishes any card. Two copies of Ice Dragon's Prison. This card has a lot of interactions with good decks. First of all, it's an out Dragoon, which this deck kind of struggled with. This deck struggles with dealing a 4,000 Dragoon unless you can get a lot of monsters on the field to go into a Boreload or a Boreload. Otherwise, you're going to have a lot of trouble. So Ice Dragon's Prison is an out to that. And there are so many cool interactions with Ice Dragon's Prisons by stealing your opponent's monsters that you can do so much stuff with this card, so I really like it. Two copies of Torrential Tribute. It's a blowout against combo decks, especially against Dragon Link. A well-timed Torrential can completely end your opponent's turn, and you don't really mind destroying your own monsters, because after you've tagged out for a Buster and have all three pieces on the field, if you Torrential your own field, you're going to get so many effects that it will be just fine. And because all the trap cards are two offs, you can probably guess that I'm playing three copies of Trap Trick, so I can get any of the traps I need for any situation. For the extra deck, I play three copies of ABC Dragon Buster. Of course, you cannot play less than three. This card is going to be your win condition. Every single game, you're going to go for the first one as soon as possible, and after you start tagging out again, you're going to be able to summon a second copy, and maybe the third copy on the same turn, which is not very possible now without being able to use stuff like Galaxy Soldier, but still, if you have an optimal hand, you can do it. And this card is just Disruption. It tags out and gives you a lot of link material, because you get three monsters, and it's much better to use the monsters you get back to Dragon Buster for links rather than Xyz. I don't play any Xyz monsters in the deck, just links, because when you link them, you're going to get their effects. If you detach them, then you're not going to. So this is why you need to be able to use your monsters more effectively in order to go for link 2s and then climb into link 4s, because of high effects of bring cards back from the grave to the hand and then special summoning them or search iron cards from the deck. So this is why getting to a link 4 with stack is very, very easy, and this is the other way you can deal with Dragoon aside from Ice Dragon's Prison. And Dragoon is going to be a card that you're going to see so much more this format, because every time a Banlist will drop, every time other decks are going to get weaker, people will opt to play Dragoon in decks that already got hit in order to make them gain back the power that it lost from the Banlist, or because other decks cannot compete with Dragoon because the decks that could just got hit. For the Link Monsters, the most important one is Platinum Gadget. Platinum Gadget is the one that's going to help you get to the combo with your Union Hunger or with your Unauthorized Reactivation. This is the only way you can get to a Dragon Buster turn 1 round that your carrier got banned, so you need to be able to play this card in order to go for the Buster turn 1. One copy of Clifford Genius. This card combos well with your Hunger, so you can negate something. It's a really, really good card. One copy of Mascarena. I usually summon this if I've used Gum on my own turn, because sometimes when I do, I'd rather summon Mascarena than just summon Omega to get rid of an opponent's random card, because when I summon Buster and I summon a Mascarena, when I tag out for my Buster, I have Mascarena three other monsters on the field. So what I can do with this, I can go for Underworld Goddess, so I can use Mascarena as a much better disruption than just sniping away a random card from my opponent's hand with Thion Omega. So this is why I think this card is much better. Play the Nightmares, one Cerberus, one Phoenix, one Unicorn, of course, removal. You can link climb very, very easily with this deck, so you can get rid of a lot of cards. And sometimes discarding cards is actually a plus for the deck, especially if you've drawn a lot of monsters. So after you you've destroyed your opponent's board with these three, then you can go for two Dragon Buster sometimes by discarding a lot of cards and linking away the rest. One copy of Boreal Sword, one copy of Boreal Load. So Boreal Sword is a good card for 40Ks because even if you summon two Busters, that's not enough to go for game, but having a Boreal Sword and a Dragon Buster on the field can go for game. And Boreal Load is the optimal out for Dragoon because, yes, you can out it with your Boreal Sword, but it's much better stealing the Dragoon than just getting rid of it because you can use its negation during your opponent's turn. Or if your opponent has a lot of monsters on the field, then you can steal Dragoon, then use its effect to pop monsters and deal damage, and sometimes you're going to win games just like that. One copy of Appaloosa. Appaloosa is a monster you can summon Mascarena if you don't decide to go for Underworld Goddess with a lot of your pieces. Because you have three pieces on the field, you can actually summon Appaloosa with four materials rather than three, because even though Mascarena is a link two, it's much better to get another interruption by having Appaloosa have more attack. And of course, if it has 3200 attack after it uses one effect, it's very difficult for your opponent to deal with it. But if it has 24 and you use one effect negation, then with 1600 attack, your opponent can run over it before you can get the chance to use another negation. One copy of Access Code Talker, another piece of Decaying, because sometimes you just don't need Boreal Sword, you need to destroy a lot of cards, so that's why it's here. One copy of Avramax. If you know you're playing against a deck that cannot deal with a Mascarena Avramax combo, then just go for it and win the game just like that. And one copy of Underworld Goddess of the Closed World. Sometimes it's much better just getting an Appaloosa on the field than this card, but sometimes Underworld Goddess can just be so much better interruption because Appaloosa negates only monster effects. There are a lot of decks that don't really care a lot about getting monster effects negated. So if your opponent's playing Eldritch, for example, it's much better to keep your Mascarena on the field until your opponent gets something on the field like an Eldritch or maybe a Zodiac monster, so you can get rid of that one important monster rather than having effect negations on the field, which are not going to be very important against decks like that. So yep, guys, I think ABC, it's a deck that's probably the most mistreated deck in history because it always ends up as collateral damage. It did not get hit when it should have been when it was meta back in 2016, and now Konami just hits other stuff that are being played in the deck because they're broken in NDR decks. And the sad part is that Union Carrier was supposed to be ABC's Link monster and ended up getting banned for another deck. So yeah, but still, the deck is still a really good deck. It's very much viable. If you have any other suggestions of how the deck can be more competitive, then comment down below. Let's have a discussion and see what the ABC player can come up with in order to make this deck as broken as possible. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss our upcoming content, and we'll see you next time.